H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to the videos of H2K Infosys. On continuation of our training on Selenium with Java, in this particular video, I'm going to show you how do you create the first Java project inside Eclipse IDE and the first Java class file inside the Eclipse IDE. So moving ahead, we are going to see that these are the topics that we are going to cover. The topics are as follows. So first we'll create a project inside the Eclipse IDE. Now after we create the project, we'll also see how do we create the first Java program inside the project. And then the third part will be explaining the hierarchy of the particular project. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and do first the process of creating the project inside the Eclipse IDE. Now for that we need to open up the Eclipse IDE as a whole. So what we need to do is we need to go to Eclipse. Out here, so I need to go to my desktop and open up Eclipse IDE and wait for the Eclipse to load first. So I need to pinpoint to the workspace that we have created the last time. The workspace that was created was workspace underscore training. So I'm going to highlight that and say okay. This pinpoints my Eclipse to this particular workspace and then click on the OK button. It takes a bit amount of time for the Eclipse to open up as it loads a lot of packages required for it to work, and it loads the packages along with the JRE system library. So as we have seen last time, we are going to create the project in the Project Explorer. Okay, the project can be created in the following manner. So what we need to do is just right click on the Project Explorer pane, choose the new option and click on the project option present out here. There are a lot of projects that we can create. So what we need to follow is choose the Java project and click on the next button. The moment we click on the next button, we can give the name of the project in this particular edit box called project name. Now, according to the coding conventions, please do not start the project name with a numeric character or a special character. Always start a project name with the alphabetical character. The Eclipse will not show you any kind of problem if we start a project with a numeric character or a special character, but it is always good that we start the project with the alphabetical character. So I will call this particular project as, let's say, first project. Note here, do not give any spaces between the two words in this particular project name. If we try to give spaces, no problem will be out there, but the stuff is that the coding convention needs to be followed, and for that we do not give spaces. The second convention is that when you give a project name, the first letter of the two words should be in capital. That is the coding convention. And we'll see that the default location in which this project gets created will be the workspace underscore training, and the path is shown out here. Do not try to change the path. The next step that we are going to see is this project that we create is going to be attached with the JRE, and it is going to get attached with the JRE system library because we can use the classes and the methods present in this JIT system library. So this will ease up our coding structure and our coding method. That is why for each project that we create, it gets attached with the JIT system library. Now we see that the first option or radio button is chosen, use an execution environment, and the environment is Java SE 1.8 version. We can change the version out here also, that's not a problem, but since the latest version is 1.8 and it is by default taking that version, do not change that. Do not choose anything else as part of this particular options given in the radio buttons, like use a project specific JRE. Do not choose it at this point of time, or do not choose this use default JRE currently 1.8.0. let it be what it is defined by default. Next thing is the project layout. So it is by default chosen as create separate folders for sources and class files. So this is going to create a separate folder for the source file and for separate folders for the class files. So choose this by default and click on the next button. This is going to create the project, and if you see, it shows you four tabs. The source tab is going to show you the project name that we have given, the first project, and inside the project we have the source folder. And then you have the projects tab, required projects on the build paths. If you want to have another project inside this first project, you can give it out here by adding it out. At this point of time, I'm not going to connect existing project with this project that I have created, that there's nothing but the first project. Libraries, you see that the JRE system library by default gets connected with first project, and this is important because then we can use the classes and the methods present in the system library for the project that we have created, that is first project. Order and export is basically used to actually connect the JRE system library with the project, that is first project. So I can select all, or I can deselect all, and then after that I can click on the finish button. And it basically asks me, do you want to change the perspective? Right now the theme that you see, which consists of Project Explorer and other coding pane and the console pane, can be changed. So this theme is pertaining to Java perspective. So I don't want to change the theme, so I click on no button at this point of time. Now this is the first project created. Now if you see, there is an arrow sign. So if you click on the arrow sign, it gets expanded. Okay, now inside the project, we're going to see two folders, that is the source folder and the JRE system library. JRE system library comes inside the first project. So every project gets connected with the system library, that is JRE system library, and it gets connected for the simple reason that the methods, classes and the interfaces that are present in the Java language can be used for this particular project, which eases out our coding behavior and coding standards. The next folder that we see inside the first project that we have created is the source folder. It is inside the source folder that we actually create class files. So as far as our creation of project is concerned, we have completed it, and that is what is shown in the slide also. This part is already completed, creation of the projects. Next, we will see how do we create the first Java program. So for that, we need to open up Eclipse again. This is Eclipse. So how do we create the first Java program? So for creation of the first Java program, what we need to do is that we need to highlight the source folder and right click. We'll get the option of new. So when we highlight the new option, we'll get an option called class. So we click on the class option, and here we can create the class file. It is in this class file that we have to write our Java codes. So please understand, at this point of time, then when we create class files, is inside this class file is the position, or inside the class file is the space where we create your Java codes. So let's see what are the options present in the class file pop-up window. It shows a source folder edit box. That means the class file is going to get created inside the source folder present inside the first project. It has a package edit box. If we do not give the package name, by default, it creates a default package. If you want to give a package name, we can give a package name. So I can give a package name as, let's say, first package. Okay, so this is the package. So this package called first package will get created inside the source folder. Okay, now if you do not give the package name, by default, the Eclipse ID will create a default package. Okay, so right now we have given a package name. After giving a package name, we have to give the class file name because we are creating a class file, a Java class file. So class file name should not start with a special character. It will show you a syntax error. It should not start with a numeric character. It will show you a syntax error. You should always have the class file name starting with the alphabetical character. So I'll call this as first class. Now if you see out here, there is a space between the first word and the second word. There is a space. Spaces are not allowed for class names. So what I need to do is that I need to remove this space. Since I have given a space, it is showing you a syntax error out here. So remove the space, first class. The moment we do that, the syntax error goes. Okay, and then I can give a numeric name without any space, or I can give, let's see, if I give a special character, I cannot give a special character. I can give a numeric name without the space. This is how we create the class. And after creating the class, what kind of modifier the class will have? There are a lot of modifiers a class can have, a public modifier, abstract modifier, or a final modifier, or a package modifier. At this point of time, we will restrict ourselves to public. We'll see what is access modifiers at a later point of time. The superclass by default, this particular edit box shows you the object. Object in Java language is considered as the superclass. So this particular class file that we have created, that is called as the first class, will be attached to this superclass by default. At this point of time, we are not using any interfaces, so leave it blank. And next part is, what methods stubs would you like to create? That means, do you want to actually use a method for this particular class? That is what it is asking. So we'll use the main method at this point of time. So we'll tick or check the checkbox for the main method. This will actually call the public static void main method inside this particular class. What is the usage of the main method? We'll see at later point of time. Okay. Are we going to use any constructors from the superclass? The superclass is object. We are not going to use any constructor from the superclass at this point of time. Leave it blank. Inherited abstract methods. What is the inherited abstract method? We'll see later point of time. But yes, it is chosen by default. Do you want to add any comment? You can generate comments for it. Let me, at this point of time, I'll not create any comments. So I will click on the finish button. The moment I click on the finish button, you will see that the class name comes out here, and this class name has a .java extension. Okay, similarly, this is the class name created inside the Project Explorer pane. Now if you see the class name, we have created the first class as the class name, and the extension of it is very important, the .java extension. And where is this class name created? First class. This class called first class is created inside the package, first package. Now if you have not given the package name, it would have created a default package by the name of default package only. Since we had given the package name, so it created the package name by the name what we had given, that is first package. And this first package is created inside the source folder.